Hey, what's up, everybody? It's your girl, Difernt, and welcome to Difernt's World YouTube channel. I hope you all out there are having a wonderful day like your girl, and if not, manifest, plan, and prepare for a better one, because I guarantee you all, it's surely coming to you guys for sure. And if this is your first, second, third time, or more to my YouTube channel, welcome, happy to have you. Before you leave, definitely hit that subscribe button and that notification bell so when I drop content, you guys come into Difernt's World, you come and learn about your girl, yeah? All right, you guys, moving right along. Today is Thursday. Happy Thursday, you guys. Wow, this year, 2023, is moving by so quickly, but we're going to keep up with it as best as we can. And so you guys know on Thursdays, we do our pop culture slash movie review. And so this one, we're going to be dropping our movie review on A Haunting in Venice. And this is the third installment of Kenneth Branagh's film series, with the first one being Death on the Orient Express, and then the second one following with Death on the Nile, and now we have a third installment, A Haunting in Venice. And I actually like mystery movies, they're my favorite. And so with this one, I was excited when it came out, went to see it in the movie theaters, definitely from the beginning tried to figure out who done it, who's doing this and that, and it wasn't what I thought at the end. And so he got me again with this one. And so before I get deep into it, guys, check out the movie trailer. And when I come back, we'll talk a little bit more about it, and then we'll talk some more news on what's going on in Difernt. Yeah, here it is.
Hercule Poirot, I've found something. I've looked at it from every which way. I am the smartest person I ever met, and I can't figure it out, so I came to the second.
You are up to something, my friend.
I've seen a million of these so-called psychics, each one a fake.
I do not believe in psychics.
Come with me to a seance. Spot the con I can't.
Detective, you are here to discredit me, but I can talk to the dead.
I'd give all I have to hear my daughter's voice.
If someone wants to be heard, we are here. Listening.
This place until I know who did it.
A ghost killed her.
There must be a rational answer for all of this.
Just admit that you are up against something bigger than you.
No!
You were saying...
Something in this house tried to kill me.
Don't look at me like I'm suspect. We're old friends.
Every murderer is somebody's old friend. No one shall leave until I find if the living have been killed by the dead.
You have been hiding here all this time.
Who are you talking to?
All right, everybody, welcome back. I hope you guys enjoyed watching that movie trailer from A Haunting in Venice. If you guys haven't gotten a chance to check it out, I'm not sure what streaming app is on right now, but I'm pretty sure it's on somebody's app. You guys just check it out. As you guys seen the movie trailer, this is, again, it picks off after what's the dude's name in the movie? Hercule Poirot, who's played by Kenneth Branagh. He's retired in Venice from his detective work, and he gets a call up from his old friend who bids him to come along to a seance on Halloween night in Venice, and all hell breaks loose when the person turns up dead. And so they had an awesome cast. They had, of course, Kenneth Branagh, Michelle Yao, Tina Fey. Who else was in it? I think Kelly Riley as well. And so if you guys haven't got a chance to check it out, definitely do so. I don't want to go into too details about it. Just my opinions and thoughts on the movie. Some of the parts that I did like, how it kept me in suspense. you know, guessing who did it and who why. Only other two things I didn't like was the two assistants in the movie that were assisting. I feel like their storyline was weak. It wasn't strong enough, and it didn't give enough detail with them. But hey, I understand they weren't the main characters. But if I had to give it a scale of 1 to 10, I'd say a 9 out of 10, because, you know, it's always room for improvement. But it's a pretty high score, if you will. And out of all three of the installments, the whodunit movies, I like to call it, I'd have to say I like the second one the best, and then the first one the second, and then this one following up, because I only got to see it one time. If I see it another time and just get into it and really be able to depict and pick away at it, then I think I'd like it a little bit more. But all in all, I like the movie with the hunting in Venice, and so I definitely recommend that you guys check it out if you haven't gotten a chance to. And if you guys like my movie review, be sure to show me by liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing. And definitely, you guys, definitely, don't forget to hit that notification bell, so when I drop content, you guys come into Difference World and see what's going on with the girl, okay? As well as moving on, you guys, don't forget to check out my website, differenceworld.net. You guys can look at all my other social media handles, including my Instagram, my TikTok, and as well as, again, my YouTube channel. So, again, go to my website, differenceworld.net, for anybody looking for motivational speakers, who likes to do collaborations, or just want to, you know, me to be part of any grassroots conversations, get at your girl. I am free of charge as of now, as well as don't forget to pop my book, What If? A Controversial Paradigm Shift, on my website as well. Again, this book was written to encourage and inform thought-provoking conversations about injustice and systemic racism in America, and I've done this through graphic and provocative illustrations. So again, please be advised that this is intended for a mature audience. It has sensitive content, and so if you can't take this type of heat, still come on to the kitchen. Just get your little fire blanket. You'll be all right. You might get a little singed, but you'll survive. That's the point of it all, you guys, is to have these conversations that need to be had that are often swept under the rug and turned a blind eye to. And so with this book and the way that I've set it up, it's meant to make you think and to push that envelope for the conversations that are swept under the rug to be had. And so go to my website and get your copy of my book, What If? A Controversial Paradigm Shift. And again, I appreciate all the love and support that I am getting and the reviews. Please keep it coming and don't stop. I'm moving right along with the Difference train. What else we got going on, you guys? So today is Thursday. You guys know on Friday, we do our travel content. And so we just dropped one of our travel videos for last week. And so I hope you guys enjoy my trip to Cuba. Should be coming actually soon, so be on the lookout. That's when why you guys gotta hit that subscribe button, that notification bell, so again, when I drop content, you guys come into Difference World and you come and learn what's going on. So again, to find out what my travel vlog and the places I visited, definitely hit that subscribe button, you guys, if you want to find out. What else we got, you guys? Moving right along, let's do our mental health check time for, again, anybody out there who may be going through any type of mental stress or anguish or illness, be it depression, bullying, having suicidal thoughts, anxiety attacks, whatever the case may be, please know that it is okay to not be okay, but don't ever sit there and not be okay. Go get help, whatever they may mean to you, be it talking with a therapist, a family member, a friend, picking up a hobby, mending broken bridges, cutting people off, even getting on medication if that is the case. Do whatever it is that you have to do to keep your mental health in check and keep you from going off the deep end and possibly taking anybody with you. If you need or if you know anybody who may need these mental health resources, please feel free to share it with them. The crisis hotline number is 1-800-273-8255, or you can call or text 988, or you can text 741-741. And for those that would prefer to go online, you guys can check out mentalhealthishealth.us, or you can visit 988lifeline.org. Or you can, for those that are outside of the U.S., you guys can check out encounselor.com. Again, that is spelled encounselling.com. And again, remember, you guys, although I am giving you these mental health resources, you have to remember it is on you to do your own homework and your own research and find what works best for you, because at the end of the day, you're the captain of your own ship and you're the one that decides to where to navigate the waters. As well as when it comes to trial and tribulations, I want you guys to remember Whatever you are going through at this time in your life, this too shall pass, and you will get through it. So going off the deep end, it's not an option. That's for, it's not worth it. So don't do it. And so just remember, you guys, to keep your mental health in check and do whatever it is that you have to do to keep from going off the deep end. And that's all we have on our bill when it comes to mental health. Yep. All right, you guys, moving right along. What else we got coming on and going on in Difference World? We got a lot going up and coming up. So again, that's why you guys got to hit that subscribe and that notification bell, so when I drop content, you guys come into Difference World and you come and learn about your girl, yeah? All right, so we're going to close this one out. Again, I hope you guys enjoyed watching my movie review on A Haunting in Venice. If you did, be sure to show me by dropping a comment, a liking, and sharing. And definitely, again, don't forget, hit that subscribe button and that notification bell. So when I drop the content, you guys come into Difference World, and I'll show you a little bit more what's going on with you, girl, yeah? So with that being said, you guys, don't forget, whatever it is in life that you're feeling you're destined for, you have to manifest, plan, and prepare for it, and then it will surely come to you guys. Difference World. Come and learn.
What if?
What if in 1619 Africans started dealing in slave trading?
The tables were turned around.
What if they kidnapped millions of Englishmen, women, and children from their homeland and brought them to America on a slave ship?
What if a controversial paradigm shift? It's a book written to inform and encourage consistent, thought-provoking conversations about injustice and systematic racism in America through graphic but provocative illustration. What If provides a different perspective by detailing controversial deaths and events as four categorized paradigm shifts: historical, political, precedent, and hypothetical. What If, a controversial paradigm shift by author Difernt. Go to differenceworld.net.